Hi, my name is Yixian Zheng.
Hi, my name is Yang Chen, a postdoctoral fellow in Yixian's lab.
Our lab at the Carnegie Institution studies cell division and genome organization in the context of development and aging. In the next few minutes, we'll describe our recent finding that uncovers the cause of aging-associated systemic inflammation and its consequences. The aging of the immune system, also known as immunosenescence, has now been suspected to contribute toward various human diseases, including cancers. However, it has been challenging to understand the cellular and molecular mechanisms that underlie the cause of immunosenescence and its consequences.
One reason for this difficulty is that the vertebrate immune system is very complicated. This slide shows you a simplified immune system and organs in humans. As you can see, humans have multiple immune organs such as the thymus and spleen, as well as the immune cells.
Compared to vertebrates, the immune system of Drosophila is quite simple. Flies have the circulating hemocytes that are equivalent to the human immune cells. The fat body, which is equivalent to the liver and fat in vertebrates, is a major immune organ that controls the humoral response of Drosophila to infections. Fat body secretes inflammatory factors into the hemolymph to aid the killing of invading microbes. In addition, organs such as the gut also modulate their local immune responses to ensure proper tissue homeostasis. To explore the cause and consequence of systemic inflammation and tissue dysfunction, we focused our study on the Drosophila fat body and intestine.
Using a combination of techniques, we found that Drosophila old fat bodies undergo increased inflammation in the absence of apparent infection. This is accompanied by the reduction of immune response in the old guts.
The question is, what causes the old fat body to undergo increased immune response in the absence of apparent infection? Our studies of nuclear organization led us to suspect that the nuclear proteins called lamins could regulate immune responses. Like the vertebrates, Drosophila also have A and B type lamins that assemble into the nuclear lamina. Lamins are known to regulate gene expression by associating with the chromatin. Interestingly, we found a significant enrichment of immune-responsive genes that are associated with the nuclear lamina in both mammalian cells and Drosophila casei cells. So it's possible that nuclear lamins play an evolutionarily conserved role in regulating the expression of inflammatory genes. Consistent with this idea, recent studies have shown that the senescence of mammalian fibroblasts in vitro is also associated with lamin B loss and the increased secretion of inflammatory cytokines and chemokines. Therefore, we asked whether lamin loss in aging fat body could lead to increased inflammation in this organ.
This slide shows the gradual loss of only lamin B but not lamin A in fat body cells upon aging, whereas lamin reduction is not seen in other tissues, such as the cell in the heart and the gut. Importantly, we found that it is the loss of lamin B in fat body that leads to the deregulation of immune response genes, which results in the elevated secretion of inflammatory factors into the hemolymph. This increased systemic inflammatory factors derived from the old fat body leads to the repression of gut local immune response, which in turn leads to the intestinal hyperplasia.
You may ask, what is the relevance of our fly study to human aging? Aging is known to be one of the major risk factors for cancer development. This graph shows the dramatic increase of colon cancer upon aging. Many colon cancers begin as polyps in people over age 50. Polyps represent a hyperplastic phenotype that is analogous to the hypoplastic Drosophila old gut. Although most polyps are benign, some will develop into cancers. Our findings in Drosophila suggests that by understanding the age-associated changes of the nuclear lamins in mammalian immune organs, we could gain important insights into how immunosenescence contributes toward tumorigenesis in elderly humans. Thanks for watching the video. For more details, please read our study published in Cell.